Witeal watch dog to investigate appointment ve grande se chairman Amir Johnson claim. The public appointment watch dog is to investigate the selection of ve grande se chairman Richard Sharp amid concerns over his role in helping Boris Johnson secure a loan. William Shawcross, the commissioner for public appointments, said is to review the way competition for the post was run to ensure it was in compliance with Witeal rules. Earlier Mr. Sharp announced that they was referring his appointment to the nominations committee of the ve grande se board following claims of a possible conflict of interest. In a letter to Shadow Culture Secretary Lucy Powell, who raised the case with him. Mr. Shawcross said that cached for relevant papers to be sent from the Department for Digital, Culture, Media and Sport. The role of the commissioner is to oversee the public appointments process and ensure appointments are made fairly, openly and on merit, commissions aside. I intend to review this competition to assure myself and the public that the process was run in compliance with the government's governance code for public appointments, commissions. Ms. Powell welcomed the announcement, saying Mr. Sharp and the government clearly have questions to answer. Earlier, Mr. Sharp insisted he was not involved in making a loan or arranging a guarantee for the then Prime Minister. But acknowledged the row is a distraction for the broadcaster. He told ve grande's staff members his role was merely to seek an introduction for some lead. Who reportedly acted as guarantor for a loan to Mr. Johnson, to the relevant official in government. He said, this matter, although it took place before he joined the ve grande's, is a distraction for the organization. Which I regret. I'm really sorry about it, all comillas. Mr. Johnson, who was responsible for Mr. Sharp's appointment dismissed as a load of complete nonsense. Insisting that Mr. Sharp had no knowledge of his personal finances. Mr. Sharp was in the process of applying for the ve grande's chairmanship when he made the introduction and was subsequently appointed to the role at the corporation. He said, he was not involved in making a loan, or arranging a guarantee, and he did not arrange any financing. What he did was to seek an introduction of some lead, seek, to the relevant official in government, commissions. He said Mr. Blit, a distant cousin of Mr. Johnson whom Mr. Sharp has known for more than 40 years, had become aware of the financial pressures on the then Prime Minister. And, being a successful entrepreneur, he told me he wanted to explore whether he could assist. Mr. Sharp, who was working in Downing Street as a special advisor to the Treasury during the pandemic, explained the situation to Cabinet Secretary Simon Case. Even to see the Cabinet Secretary and explained who Sam was, and that, as a cousin of the then Prime Minister. He wanted to help him if possible, commissions Mr. Sharp said. He also reminded the Cabinet Secretary that he had submitted my application for the position of ve grande's chairman. We both agreed that, to avoid any conflict, it should have nothing further to do with the matter. At that point there was no detail on the proposed arrangements and yet no knowledge of whether any assistance was possible, or could be agreed. Since that meeting I've had no involvement whatsoever with any process. Even now. I don't know any more than is reported in the media about a loan or reported guarantee, commissions. In his message to ve grande's staff, Mr. Sharp said asked the nominations committee of the corporation's board to look at the matter to ensure all the appropriate guidelines have been followed within the ve grande's since he have joined. Mr. Johnson sought to brush off the controversy, the Shingeski news, this is a load of complete nonsense, absolute nonsense. Let me just tell you, Richard Sharp is a good and wise man who knows absolutely nothing about my personal finances, I can't tell you that for 100% ding dang sure. This is just another example of the ve grande's disappearing a pizza un fundament commissions. The Tales of the Saga Around M.R. Johnson's Personal Finances were reported in the Sunday Times and were seized on by opposition MPs. Canadian Education Entrepreneur M.R. Blitzside the Guarantee provided a for less than the reported sum of up to 800 libras, 000. The Guarantee that was provided was much less than reported and was pre-approved by the Cabinet Office and the TICs prior to it being put in place, comillas se told the National Post in Canada. Prime Minister Rishi Sunak said the chairman went through a rigorous and transparent recruitment process. Added, this appointment was obviously made by one of my predecessors before I became Prime Minister. The appointments process itself for appointing the chairman is a rigorous process. It is independent, there are two stages to it, it is transparent and published online. M.R. Sharp's appointment went through that full process, comillas. The Liberal Democrats side the 115 libras, 000 allowance for M.R. Johnson to run his office as ex-prime minister should be withdrawn until answers questions about his financial arrangements. The party's chief whip, Wendy Chamberlain, said, Boris Johnson has a dismal track record of avoiding scrutiny and covering up his less and the site. When I was only interested in following the money, so it's time to hit him where it hurts, if I said comillas.